Hi, everyone. Today I'm going to show you my experiment on using swarm intelligence. I've called the project Screaming Insects. I'd like to note that the exact definition of swarm intelligence is still not formulated. Let's open Wikipedia and read the definition. The agents follow simple rules, and although there is no centralized control structure dictating how individual agents should behave, local and to a certain degree random interactions between such agents lead to the emergence of intelligent global behavior, unknown to the individual agents. By intelligence here, we mean not that a swarm of agents will begin to raise philosophical questions, but the fact that they will jointly solve a problem, the solution of which is not obvious from a simple algorithm of the agent, but is revealed in their joint actions. Well, here's today's task for the screaming insects: to look for resources and deliver them to the base. On the right side of the screen, you see what we're going to have at the end of the video. The agents are looking for resources and deliver them to the base. The agent's algorithm is very simple. The agent is blind, walks crookedly, and can only contact the nearest agents. But, acting together, they quickly find a resource and a short path to the base. The topic is very interesting. Researchers are trying different approaches. In my opinion, this will become widespread when the agents are located on different physical devices, and there will be a problem in creating a centralized management. Let's get back to the Screaming Insects project. This is our agent. He has a direction, and his task is to run between point A and point B. Now he needs to find point A. Since there are only two agents, the agent has two counters, in which the estimated number of steps to each point is recorded. With each turn, these counters increase by one, no matter which direction the agent is going. And with every turn, he shouts out the value of one of his counters plus 50. 50 is the maximum distance at which his scream can be heard. He sort of notifies everyone who hears him that there is the same number of steps to this point as for him, plus an additional 50 steps. The agent doesn't see anything, moves by touch, and must bump into an item to understand that he has arrived at his destination. Here, the agent has bumped into one of the items, perhaps by accident. He is resetting the counter corresponding to this item. If this is exactly the item that he has been looking for, he will turn 180 degrees and continue to move on. Now he needs to find point B. And here is where the magic happens. He is heard by the second agent located within a radius of 50 steps. The second agent compares the value he hears with the value from his counter. If the values heard are less, the second agent updates his counter corresponding to point A. That is, he writes down the value that he has heard. Now he believes that there are 51 steps from him to point A, 50 steps to the first agent, and one more step to point A. If the second agent was moving to point A, then he would turn in the direction of the shouting. But now he is going to point B. Now the second agent notifies the others that they are 101 steps from point A. That is, 50 steps to reach it, and from there to point A, 51 steps. This was heard by the third agent. He updates his counter, and as he is going to point A, he turns in the direction of shouting. Please note that the direction of the third agent has become even worse than before. This will often happen locally, but globally, abstract swarm intelligence will see the whole picture through the gradient of counter values for agents, and as a result, all agents will reach their destination. So here's the agent's algorithm. Take a step and increase all the counters by one. If you bump into one of the items, reset the respective counter. If this is the destination you were willing to reach, turn around 180 degrees and change the destination objective in your head. Shout out the value of one of your counters plus the maximum distance you can be heard at. Listen to what the others are shouting. If you have heard a value less than in your counter, update the respective counter and turn in the direction of the shouting if you need to reach this place. First implementation. Here, the agent must shuttle between the two bases. The operation principle is slightly different from what I have described before, but the picture has turned out to be interesting, so I will show it here. There are 1,600 agents on the field, and a shout-out can be heard at a distance of 38 pixels. To understand the scale, I will put a ruler with a scale of 38 pixels and circles with the same radius. Lines will be displayed on the screen, connecting the one who shouts and the one who is listening, provided that the shouting has led to a counter update. The main difference is that the agent only shouts out when one of his counters is updated, so the initialization of the shout wave comes from one of the bases, and then the wave passes where the distance between the agents allows. After some time, something like paths begin to form. I'm starting the video. Most of the time, agents walk in silence, but even such uncommunicative agents have managed to build a path in the end. Critically important here is the number of agents per unit area and also the range of the shout-out. Reducing the distance even by one pixel leads to the fact that the path is created much longer. Now I've sped up the playback for you to see that, over time, the path tends to become straight. Also, the system has a feature that is a direct consequence of the operation principles. In the presence of two paths, the longer path dies off immediately. In the end, I have come to the conclusion that with each turn, agents should report the state of one of their counters. Now I will show you some interesting points that I have pointed out during the experiments. We have two blue bases on the right side and orange resources on the left side. Let's launch the agents. The agents have found all the targets, but look what happens. The central resource is closer to the bases than other resources, and therefore, the agents prefer to go only where it's located. And the central resource is closer to the higher base, so the agents prefer to carry the resource to this base. This is exactly the feature I was talking about. Long paths die off quickly. Sometimes it's helpful, sometimes it's harmful. For example, in the final implementation, each agent is assigned exactly which of the resources he should bring, so that he is not distracted by the nearest ones. And one more thing, the path has been formed. I put the resource next to the path, but since the agents are blind, they will walk by. Therefore, in the final version, some of the agents are scouts who do not deliver the resource, but simply survey the surroundings and help transmit messages. And here's one more trick. The resource has disappeared, and now the agents begin to move in a wide fan. This helps to find the resource faster. And this happens because after each step, they randomly change direction by a small angle. They cannot walk straight. See what would happen if they could walk straight? And the last moment here, the agents should not only walk crookedly, but they should also have different speeds. If you set the same speed for everyone, the path often gets destroyed, turning into a group that roams to one point and then all together to another. It seems that we have mentioned all the points. And now, we are moving on to the final implementation of the Screaming Insects project. So, the legend goes as follows. There are three types of resources: red, green, and blue. These are agents going after a red, green, and blue resource. And this is how they look like when they have grabbed the resource and are carrying it back to the queen. Also, among the agents, there are scouts who move around the area and don't have a particular goal to find resources. But if they bump into a resource, they carry it to the queen. And this is the queen. The circle in the center shows her health state. Let's go. To challenge it a bit, resources are constantly moving. Moreover, the queen herself is constantly on the move, shifting towards the furthest resource. The agents have a lifespan, and eventually they will die. But the queen, if all the three resources are brought to her, can create a new agent. Or with some probability, she can spend the resource on extending her life. Besides, any agent being 1,000 steps from the queen can declare himself the queen, start shouting around the district that the queen is only 50 steps away, take resources from the approaching agents, and create new ones. On the screen, you can already see how new queens are appearing. By the way, the agents don't care about whose queen it is, and carry resources to where it is closer. Newly emerged queens need to quickly get all the three resources to have enough time to prolong their lives. It all depends on good luck. It is necessary to be close to resources and have many agents nearby. Resources are of a fairly small capacity. A swarm of agents devastates them in just a few seconds. Few resources manage to get away if they are discovered by the swarm. The only salvation is if the same resources are located nearby and the agents switch to them. Well, next I'll share my fantasies. There are caravans, so you need to learn how to rob them and take your prey to your queen. Or we can create an economic simulation. Each queen sets her own price for each resource. The agent must decide whether to carry them close but be paid cheap, or move them far, but for a high price, although facing a risk to be robbed. And all this to save up to buy a house and retire. Speaking of construction, I would like agents to not only carry resources, but also to engage in construction. I found an algorithm online showing how termites build their termite mounds. Guided by this algorithm, thousands of unorganized insects build a complex multi-tiered maze as a result. They have no plans, no blueprints. But I still couldn't understand it. Perhaps you have some ideas on how to implement this. Please leave your comments. Thanks to everyone who supports us on Patreon. More support, more opportunities for new projects. Well, that's all for now. Bye, everyone.